Afternoon all. This series of videos is going to be dedicated to the top end rebuild of a Lister D type. I'm going to try and attempt to show you how to do it, things to watch out for, and just a general, we're going to do a decoke on the engine, general clean out, valve grind, it'll involve removing the valves, rockers, we'll be taking the cylinder head off and changing the head gasket, as it's just started to leak when it's running a load on the dynamo. So I shall try and keep these videos as short as possible. Yeah, that's pretty much it, I think. So I hope you enjoy these and find them useful. Right, well, the first job is to disconnect this linkage here, which is the governor rod, controls the governor butterfly. So what we need to do is remove the little split pin here. I'll just try and turn it round for you so you can see it. So the way we're going to do this, we're just going to try and press the end of it down so it'll come out, and I think we should be able to just pull the thing out like so. So what we're now going to do, just slide this pin out here, this one. And I think, there we are, we should be able to disconnect the governor rod like so. And for the sake of not losing bits, I'm just going to reattach this. And it's a good idea if you put the pin back in. So, we might need pliers for this. What we'll try and do, squeeze this down, and we should be able to feed it back into the hole. Funny thing, split pins. There we are, like so. So that won't get lost now. I don't recommend removing the carburetor or the fuel tank unless you think you're likely to break something. So I'm going to try and be careful. So you don't need to remove the fuel line, but you do need to remove the HT lead. So that's the next job. So as I said, you need to remove the HT lead, but it's also a good idea to remove the spark plug. Just removes any compression that may be there. Now, word of warning, don't try and turn the engine over with the HT lead off. You can actually blow the coil like that, and that's very expensive. About 60 quid you'll end up having to fork out. So correct plug spanner, and it should come out. There we are. Now we're going to remove the hopper cover and the rocker box cover. We need to be careful of the gasket under there. It is a new one I made about a year ago, but they can stick to things and it's very easy to rip them or any paper. So I'm going to use a ring spanner. They're always best as they don't round off the nuts, or the bolt head rather. So yeah, nice and loose. You want to take them off evenly. There we are. So now we're going to try and carefully remove these. It doesn't matter what order you do it. You see, if you put grease on the underside of the gasket when you put it on, it should just stay down when you lift the covers off, like that. So we'll put those aside for safekeeping. Well, this is the next problem we face. The rocker shaft, rockers and push rods down there all have to come out. You don't leave the push rods in. Some people do like to do that, but you can easily lose them down in the sump, which will make your life very, very difficult. So what we need to do, these two set screws, one, two, they need to be removed, and then the greaser, which is on this end, you can just see it in the bottom left of your screen, that needs to come off. I think we'll need to undo the nut and we should be able to draw the whole thing out. We'll need to be careful not to drop any of these spacers, so it's important to remove them as the whole thing comes out, one at a time, lay them out in order. I think I'm right in saying that this centre bushing is a slightly different size to the ones here. They're very similar, but you could get them mixed up. Also, it's important to say that the exhaust valve and the inlet valve are different, so you mustn't get them mixed up. So we'll remove these set screws and try and remove the thing. Right, well, we're going to remove these set screws. So I've got a socket on the ratchet here, and this is a 9/16 socket that seems to fit okay. So we're just going to loosen them. Yep. And I've got one on to the side. I'm wearing gloves for this because otherwise it gets very messy. So we'll just loosen them and then take them out by hand. Whatever you do, try not to drop them in the sump. Now I've said that, let's see what happens. I can feel it getting quite loose now, so just being a bit careful. Here we are. That's all it is. So I'll remove the other one and then we should be able to slide the valves out. So we'll see what happens then. Well, I've got the set screws out now and I've just got the greaser to move. So we're going to try and very carefully pull the greaser out, and hopefully that will allow us to move the spacers and the rockers. Now I'm going to have to do this quite slowly, or I'm going to end up in a bit of a mess, so bear with me. Might need to push it through from the other side. In fact, I think we might even need a spanner on the rockers, on the shaft rather. So let's try that. So if we rotate it, we should be able to pull it out. There we go. Ah, yes, it's coming now. So, fingers either side of one spacer. I've no idea how far I've got to go. That's it, first spacer out. So we're going to lie them down exactly as they come out on the workbench. Then afterwards it's a good idea to clean everything up and label it. That's absolutely key. Yep. We've got the rocker coming off. There it is. And an interesting goo in the pushrod cup there. So we're going to lay that out as it was. Centre bushing. And you can see why I'm wearing gloves now. The last rocker. And it looks like the bushing is going to come with it. That's the rocker anyway. Some very odd stuff in there, looks like copper grease. So yeah, it's another reason to wear gloves, not something you want in your hands. Last spacer. And finally, we should be able to extract the rocker shaft now. Like so. That's it. Now it's a jolly good idea to reassemble all that on the workbench so you're not going to lose any bits. So the next thing we're going to do is just lift out the pushrods. Like so. Now, on the end there, that's the cup which the bottom of the rocker sits in, so you don't want to lose that. And that sits in a cup on the rocker, right down working on the cam in the crankcase. So We must remember that that is the left-hand valve. Next push rod. There we go. I think it's fair to say all this stuff needs a jolly good clean. So do my hands. Right, so look, we've even got a dead bug in there. So yes, we're going to try and clean that out now. Oh, and these are the next two head nuts there. They're just standard ones. So yeah, we're going to remove the head now. Something else I've just removed, which I forgot in the last clip, was to remove the valve caps, which are on these two here. They just sit on the top and protect the little pin there and give the rocker something to press on. As you can see, the valves are quite easy to press by hand. But anyway, now we're going to remove the head bolts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, it's important to remember here that you need to release them evenly. This might be cast iron. Twisting is more of a problem on alloy engines, but nonetheless it could be a problem here, so we're going to be careful. Now, I have actually loosened all of these, but I've just re-tightened them a little to show you the idea. You might need to use a bar, but don't apply too much force. They're only thin studs and they're easy to break. So I think we're going to start with the front here. We're just going to loosen them a tiny bit. So I can get the ratchet working like that. I'm going to do one of these at the back, working a sort of diamond shape. We'll just nip that one up a little more, actually, too loose. Then we're going to do this one. Oh, it's tight. and then the final one here. I think that's all of them. Now that they're all loose, in fact we can just loosen them even more. And we've got a stuck socket. I hate it when that happens. Bear with me a moment, please. Right. Do the one on to the side. They're loose enough now. Front ones. I did just nip some of these up slightly, as I thought I'd undone them too much. And hopefully we'll be able to remove these by hand. Right. See what we can do. And again, these must be laid out as they were. It's just a good idea. There should be washers under these. Well, through the rust I can't really tell, but I can see something brass or bronze, so I assume that's what it is. So we might need to pick those off with a screwdriver. Cheap screwdrivers are fantastic for things like that. It just means you're less likely to break anything. Yeah, definitely washes under those. And I think we're going to end up making a new gasket. But, no hard bun. Now we'll just loosen the back too. Sorry if this is a bit long-winded, but useful to show it all. Right, so that's all the head nuts removed. So just set these out on the worktop. And I think everything's going to need a soak in paraffin just to wash off all the grease and oil. It's much nicer to work with them. So we'll try and get those washers out. There are some on the back there. We probably won't get those out until we clean it. So we're going to try and pull this off next. So I hope that's helpful to some people. And like I say, the most important thing, just to undo it all evenly, and it's the same when you put it back. So just want to even out the stress on the casting. The next job now is to lift the cylinder head off. Now once again, it's very important to do that evenly. Now it's okay to hold the exhaust if you hold it right near the block. That's good and strong. You could probably lift the engine by that, though I wouldn't recommend it. I've put the plug in to help lift by, but again, don't put undue force on that. It's easy to rip the threads, so only once you've got it loose. Now I have loosened this. I was able to just do it by holding the casting, cocking it a bit. I don't recommend using chisels or anything like that in there. Definitely not, as you can damage the sealing surfaces. So we're going to lift it off now, evenly. We don't want any force on the studs. We don't want to bend them. So it's also a good idea to have some wood on the floor or something where you can put it. So there's some over in the corner, which will be okay. Right, so here we go. See, I think the plug's probably not the best thing to hold. Let's see. Okay. There we are. Well, there is the cylinder. It's about 40 years worth of grub in there. It was restored over 40 years ago, this one, so well in need of a clean. As you can see, water's been obviously getting into the gasket. You can see it actually sitting on the surface there. Some of this may have come out from the hopper when we lifted it, but at the back it really shouldn't be there, even from that. Very oily piston. I can't move it around too much in the bore, so that's good. Studs all look straight. So that's what we want. Carbon from these engines is horrible. You want to try and avoid getting that on your skin, because it takes ages to wash out. So I'll just show you the cylinder head. Well, here's the cylinder head. Lots and lots of dirt built up all around the water jacket, so we'll give that a good clean. But most noticeable is all the dirt in here. Now I just grab a torch so I can show you that. Very, very carboned up, as you can see. But something also to note, I said about the valves being different. You notice this one, the head of the valve is much larger. That is the exhaust valve. This here is the inlet valve, and you can just see the track going to it there in the water jacket. The exhaust track goes back round there. Now this is quite carboned up. It's probably a lot better than it was since I started running it on the generator, but it does need work. I've also noticed a couple of marks here. Now I wonder if that means it's been rebored oversized, so I'm just going to investigate that.